What we see with the disciples of Jesus today is the natural instinct of every one of us. The natural desire to be celebrated, to be the greatest, in many ways, in many forms. And it is not something bad at all for anyone to desire to be on top or to be the greatest of all. Perhaps in music, in writings, in poetry, in whatever endeavor or career or job or life. That is the natural instinct. And sometimes we can find ourselves privileged in some positions of life. That is not the question. The question here is, being placed on those strategic positions, how do we serve? How do we see ourselves? Using the example of the little ones, Jesus called the attention of the disciples. If you would like a deeper understanding, at the time of Jesus, children were not counted as anything, along with women, but over time, with understanding, we have come to know so much about women and children. Consider the other story we read the other time about the feeding of the 5,000. It says, excluding women and children. The patriarchal influence goes into some of the writings there, but that is not what we are discussing. So we children were not, you know, privileged at that time, you know, to be on any position of honor. And of course, when we get a child, so many things a child can teach us: the simplicity, the humility, and the dependence. And with all of that, we come to see how all of us are called to be like children, to depend totally on God who sustains us. In that way, we imitate Jesus Christ himself. Though privileged, you see that in Paul's letter to the Philippians chapter 2. Being discerned equality with God, he did not hold on to that position, but he humbled himself to be obedient and became man in all things. So in life, we can find ourselves in so many positions, but not to hold on to those places of honor, but to use those positions to serve others. In that way, we hug into the words of the Lord, becoming a sweet taste in our mouth. And also today we celebrate a very special person, St. Clare. In 2015, I was privileged to visit Assisi, the village where she started her ministry. Not 2 miles away from where you have the building of St. Francis of Assisi. This virgin, she heard Francis preaching in the street. And like Ezekiel, she found so much treasure in the preaching of, in the sermon of St. Francis. So much so that she started organizing other young ladies to devote themselves to the life of chastity and to promote the goodness. Today the church brings her as an example. And each time we celebrate the saints, it is a reminder that we all are called to be saints. And our sainthood begins here and now, and not after, by the way we react and speak and relate with one another. May all of these sweet promises of the Lord in the scripture become so sweet in our mouth. Through Christ our Lord.